this is the Provoked Prawn, and this is a video on Noctua's fans, specifically on the NF-A12x25. These are 120mm premium fans from Noctua that are designed to offer excellent cooling performance with PWM control and superior performance over and above a lot of the other fans in the industry. They're renowned for being particularly good, and in this video I'm going to show you why and how to install them, the things that are included in the box, and talk to you about the various highlights of them. Now, when I unboxed these fans, I was immediately struck by the overall quality of them. They're nice, solid, heavyweight fans with a really good design on them. And there are a number of interesting highlights to them. Now, these aren't cheap. They're quite expensive. But the reason for that becomes quite apparent when you get them out of the box and then start to install them and use them. Now, you can see these aren't RGB and they're not black. They're very striking in their color makeup. But beyond that, they're also interesting for a number of reasons. They're very solidly built with a really solid setup that includes steel and brass internals, as well as a liquid crystal polymer compound as well in there. So there's some serious business. You'll also notice that it has anti-vibration rubber mounts around the outside and a very premium sticker on the rear. It also has an interesting design with a stepped housing that encourages the air through from the front and reduces things like vibrations and other noise. Inside the box, you also get a low noise adapter that sets the fans to run at 1700 RPM instead of 2000 maximum. So it actually chills things out immediately. It wants to make it quieter. You also get an extension cable, which gives you a bit more length in the cables, as well as a Y splitter cable, which allows you to essentially plug two cables into one fan head on your motherboard. I'm going to show you the process for doing this a bit later on, because it can get a bit messy. And if you have a multitude of fans that I do here, for example, then you need to work out where you're going to plug them in on your fan headers, because you might find you have a limited number on your motherboard. So some thought needs to go into how you're going to do that. And I'll explain what that means later on, how to do it. But it is nice that all these things are included. The other thing you'll find in the box is this rubber outer housing. The logic for this is that you can replace the standard rubber bungs around the outside, and then you can use this on a radiator. So for example, for an all-in-one cooler, you can use these fans on there and get improved performance. You'll also find these bits of rubber can be used to attach the fans to your case. That obviously helps to reduce the overall noise levels and minimize vibration noise and things like that. So instead of using screws, you can use these, and there's instructions on the box on how to do that. You also find traditional screws if you prefer to make sure things are nice and tight to the case as well. So what you're already seeing is a really interesting design with a number of highlights to it, and it's really hard to put across in video just sort of the premium feel of a fan. Really good build quality and a nice solid design. It also obviously is multifunctional since it will work with radiators as well, so it offers good static pressure and excellent cooling performance no matter what you're doing with it, whether it's intake, exhaust, or being used on a fan. So another close-up look at these cables. Simple little cables, tiny little no-noise adapter, basically allows you to reduce the maximum speed without having to mess around in the BIOS or within software settings. The Y cable definitely makes life a lot easier, allowing you to plug in two fans into one port, and then you have the extension cable. The extension cable, I found, is also pretty important if you want to make things tidy in your case, because what I found is that especially when you have that Y cable plugged in, you end up with quite a lot of chunky looking cables at the front of your case, and it can end up looking a bit messy. So I ran this extension cable through to the rear of the case and then back through to the front, and this allows to make things a little bit neater. It's worth bearing in mind also the required voltage for these fans and what your header on your motherboard is giving off. So I wouldn't recommend necessarily stacking loads of them together. I've seen people in other videos suggesting that you could put multiple different fans into this by stacking Y cables on top of each other, and then for example having four cables running into one and then putting that in the header. That certainly wouldn't be a good idea. You will find that each motherboard offers a different power for each of the fan headers on your motherboard, and it potentially could cause problems. Two is probably a safe bet. Any more might be a bit risky. What you can see here is a comparison with the 140mm fan from Noctua, which I was using as part of the air cooler that I installed from the CPU, and you'll see, again, similar sort of overall design to it, and an excellent quality. And a close-up look at it, you'll see the little highlights, like the fins on the fan itself, everything marked to push towards that airflow. And a close-up look, you'll see that, for example, there's these rings on the inner edge of the fan, and that all is designed to help pull that cold air in and make it run well. Now a quick look at how I installed them in my case. So this is the Lian Mini Snow Edition, and I've installing a multitude of fans in here in a variety of positions, exhausting air out the top and intaking from the bottom and that rear panel. And the installation here, I was using the screws to hold it into place and setting it up. And as I said, the cables, I'll show you in a second, will be running into the back and then back through to the front. Now, combined with the motherboard that I'm using, the good thing about this is you can adjust the fan speed control, and you can also set these fans into a zero RPM mode. So as well as going up to 2000 RPM maximum, and obviously delivering really fast cooling, but in a less obnoxious way than some other fans, because these give a good sound when you're using them, although quite loud, depending on how many you've got, they also will run quietly, and I'll show you that in a second. Now, with this motherboard, there are several different fan header ports on here, and it's worth bearing in mind which ones you're using. You'll see two, for example, underneath the CPU itself, and then there's another two underneath the SATA power connections there. So you have reasonable access to some there, and there's another one at the bottom. There's also, obviously, for the CPU itself, there's two at the top. You have a standard CPU fan header, and there's an additional optional one here. But you can see there's a limited number of system fan headers and chassis fan headers essentially on the motherboard, so you really need to plan out. If you bear in mind, for example, that as 8 fans, then you can see I only have 5 headers, so if you're using the trying to connect them individually with each one, you're going to come unstuck. So the Y splitter cables become essential. To make things a lot easier, I basically use the Y splitters on every single cable, and then an extension lead. So running those Y splitters to the back, because you can see once you've put 2 cables into one, you then have a lot of connectors and extra cables, and it starts to look messy. So if you have space to run them to the back, you can then tidy things up and make it a bit neater, and then run them back through to the front with the extension lead. I'll leave all the specifications of these fans in the description, because there's lots of highlights and features that are worth knowing. But hopefully this has given some interesting insight into how to set them up and how I did it. I've found that the cooling performance is excellent, and the fact that you can run them in zero RPM mode means that you can basically make them really quiet when they're not needed, when the fans are, when your case is at a good temperature and it's already cool enough and you don't need to make it extremely, extremely cool or to bring the temperature down at all. So a look at the finished product, and you can see some of the cabling here. You'll note, for example, that one of the cables from the rear for that exhaust fan is sort of messy, and but I could perhaps sort of install this in another way, but it's just plugged into underneath the CPU header. But I figure once the GPU's in, you probably won't notice that quite as much, and the overall finish is quite good. Now, in the BIOS settings and in software, you may find things like fan control. For example, you'll see in the ROG Armory crate, there's a fan speed setting here and AI cooling. If I select silent in that middle setting, that then puts the fans into the minimum spinning. You can also adjust the fan control within the motherboard settings and tweak when the fans will spin and what levels they'll spin at. And that's a different video entirely, but this sort of software makes life a lot easier. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Hope you found this video useful. Thanks for watching. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Hope you found this video useful, interesting, hilarious, or otherwise. Take a look at these other videos that I think you might find interesting as well. And have a look at the description for links and other information you might find useful. Click that join button to see the benefits of being a member of my YouTube channel. And most importantly, have a great life.